What's up, everyone? It's your boy NornRad89 here, bringing you another rad movie review today. We're going to be talking about Friday the 13th Vengeance, a Friday the 13th fan film currently on YouTube for free. I just watched it and everything and had to drop a review on it. So hopefully you guys stick around and see what I have today. Spoiler warning ahead too. We're going to be talking some spoilers and everything. So if you haven't seen it, go watch it, then come back and watch this video. Now let's get into it. Roll it. So, Friday the 13th, Vengeance, a fan film currently on YouTube, directed by Jeremy Brown and everything. A friend of mine did a review on it, and I found out about this film, and I had to run over and watch it, and then I had to do a review on it because it was just... it's that good, for real. It's definitely a recommend watch from me, for sure. It has a great feel and everything, so let's get down to talking about it. So right off from the bat, we start off that we're going from Friday the 13th Part 6 to this film. So we're going to ignore 7, 8, 9, and Jason X. All that's ignored and everything, so we go directly from Part 6 to this one. And in all honesty, as a fan of Friday the 13th, this is the film that we deserved. Like, as the Friday the 13th Part 7, this is what I wanted back in the 80s for the after 6, you know what I mean? Like, they carry on, they continue from giving us more stuff about Tommy Jarvis. We get his daughters introduced into this film and everything, which I like the older daughter actress a bit, but the one with the beanie, the younger one, I wasn't too pleased with her, but it was just good to introduce them, because when you introduce characters like that, especially with the Jarvis trilogy and everything, being a Friday the 13th fan, you instantly pull us in and we're interested in the story and stuff like that. We also get an introduction to some other characters like Elias Voorhees, Jason's dad and everything, so that gives us a whole nother layer and a whole nother level to the story in this film and everything. They do some great things where they call back to a lot of the other films, showing us that this is definitely a film that is going to be considered canon and like part of the franchise by most fans, probably, because it has a lot of callbacks and it fits well into the story and everything. And Elias Voorhees is played by C.J. Graham, who was great portrayal. His scenes and his portrayal of Elias Voorhees was great in the film. It was definitely interesting. His scenes were all interesting, stuff you wanted to watch and everything, so that's why I liked it and everything. It was a really good character to add into this film. The like demonology thing with the book, and he saves Jason from the water and everything, and he resurrects Jason back to life, that I was like, it was a little weird, a stretch, but like I was cool with Jason Goes to Hell, so I was comfortable with it. It was a weird stretch, but I was comfortable with it, so it was good, you know what I mean? So the writing in it and the pacing in this film is really good too. It's just very interesting from the get-go and stuff. It grabs you and it keeps you going. And it has an hour and a half, like an hour and 35 minute runtime. So that's great. Like, it has an actual legit film runtime and everything. So it's enjoyable. I loved every minute of it and stuff. And oh, and just bringing Jarvis into it, Elias Voorhees, were all great things that I liked as a fan and everything. It was very enjoyable. And we also have to talk about the production value. The production value in this film was top notch. Like, you cannot tell this was a fan film. It looks legit like a film that you would go see in the theaters for Friday the 13th. That's why I liked it too. The design of Jason, the mask, the suit, calling back to Friday the 13th Part 6, Jason Lives, which is my favorite Jason film. It was definitely really good, spot on. I loved it and everything. The kills are just so gory, so gruesome, very Jason style. Like, there's this one where he grabs this guy by the head and just pulls him up, and you see his spine come out of his back and he lifts the head off. Like, oh, really good kill, you know what I mean? Like, I like those good practical prosthetic kills. You know, I'm not a good fan, a big fan of CGI, so those practical, more prosthetic kills are definitely more in my area and everything. And we also get some tits in this movie, so if you're into tits and hits, this is your film for sure. So that's definitely going to get a nod over some of the other fan films in my book, because when you go to see a Friday the 13th film, you want to see some tits and you like the kills and everything, so those things have to be top notch, you know, sometimes more important than even the story. So that's why this film gets a nod over some of the other fan films and everything. Right now, Vengeance would be the one that kind of set the bar. Like, Never Hike Alone, I really liked. Voorhees was good. but Vengeance kind of set the bar right now as for Friday the 13th fan films that I've seen and everything that I want and everything. And I hope they do this kind of style or story with a Jason film. I think it would be really cool and everything. Either this or they'd have to change the whole thing. They'd have to reboot Jason again or carry on and do something similar like this. Like, it could be interesting because we've already gotten the Friday the 13th remake, but to get another one that maybe kind of starts off as the next part 7 and just continues off with the Tommy Jarvis stuff, that could be interesting. Fans might be down to see that, and I would definitely go to the theaters to see that. So, you know, big production companies, maybe they're listening, hopefully, you know, and hopefully they get out of the court system eventually. But this is definitely, as a fan, I think the film that we deserved as a part 7 after part 6, really great. The only problems, negatives I had, the one daughter that I didn't like with the beanie, I hated that character. I hated that character. Every other character I loved in this film. The darkness of the film, some of the scenes were really dark. I couldn't enjoy what I was watching. Like, I wanted to enjoy the kills more and some of the, but I was squinting at the scene. Maybe I have to watch it on a different TV or like at night or something, but I was squinting at the screen trying to see, like, it was really dark, some of the scenes. So, but besides that, everything else was spot on point. The music was on point. They got Harry Manfredini to come back. They got a lot of callbacks. Tom McLaughlin is in this film. We got CJ Graham in this film. Like, there is some awesome stuff in this film. This is a Friday the 13th film that I will consider as a very high up on my list. If I ranked them all, including the fan films, this would actually be probably really high up there, you know, close to the top 10 or in the top 10 for sure. Definitely. So, I would really urge people to go out and watch this film. I'll have a link in my description down below so you can go check it out and everything and all that. Hopefully you guys want to run over there, and I hope you enjoy it. Leave your comments down below and everything. Let me know what you thought. But overall, in my book, being a Friday the 13th fan and loving the franchise, this is going to get a hard 9 for me. I would buy this film. This is going to be a 9 out of 10 in my book for sure. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the review. Thanks for sticking around with me. Leave your likes and everything and subscribe and all that stuff. Hopefully we can reach like 500 subscribers or 1,000 subscribers. That would be amazing and everything. Maybe we'll do something cool on the channel and all that stuff. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. Peace out.